guys, it's Ayan Wizard. I'm finally back with a new video. I've not made a video for a long, long time. But now I'm here, so let's get started.
Basically, I'm going to demonstrate how to do shading on a pear.
So first, we have to take a normal pencil. I'm just using this pencil. I'm going to use a normal eraser for this video.
So now, those are the materials. Let's start with the real drawing. First, you have to make a little curved. You have to make a little curved rectangle like this. So it has to be curved. So it will look basically like this when you make a curved rectangle. So it should be curved like that. Then after you do that, you make a dot in the middle, and then you go up. But when you go up, you go little bit out, not following the same path, but little bit out like that. And the lines which are inside, you have to erase all of them. Now after you do that, the bottom line, we have to erase that, and then we have to extend this a little bit. But you have to still follow the curve of this. You have to just follow the curve like that. Now we are done with the stem. To make this look like a 2D stem, but to make it look like realistic, to make it look 3D, we have to erase this. And then after we erase the top part, then we have to make a small oval at the top. So the small oval will look like this. And now it looks little bit like it's 3D. So that's how you draw your stem. Now we're going to start with making the pear shape. So actually the pear. So first you have to go like you have to go little up. You can see the stem, like little up from the stem. You have to make two dots like that, and then you have to start making your circle. This circle has to be little bits, like it should be it's fine if it's not perfect, but it should be little bit like ovaled. It should not be like a perfect circle. And then for the second circle, you have to just 1 centimeter gap, just leave 1 centimeter gap, and make a big circle, little bit bigger than this. So make a circle again. So after we got both of the circles, it should be proper with both of the sides. So you can basically make a line through the middle, and these four parts at the top and also in the bottom circles should be equal. So after you did that, then you have to make a curve which goes right here. So you have to make that in both of the sides, a curve which is going right, like literally connecting both of these circles. So you have to make a curve like this. And then after you make that curve, these inner lines, you have to erase those. Also the middle line, if you made it, then you have to erase it too. So I'm just fixing this time, I raised it a bit. And this is the shape. Now take a pen. I forgot to tell you, we have to use a pen, but you also need a pen. So you have to trace all the out. We are done with the tracing. Let's go to the shading. So we're done with the sketch. We're done with our first step, which is the sketching. Now let's do the shading. So we are going to make the light come from this side. The light is going to come from this side. That means this part is going to be dark. So So from the top, we are going to just, we have to press hard. If we take a pencil and press it hard, we have to just make small strokes. So basically strokes are you're making lines on the paper. So you have to make small strokes, and the more down you go, the bigger the strokes will get. And then when you reach really close to when the pear starts curving inside, then you have to stop. And you have to not start shading from here. You have to start shading from here. So I will draw a line. You can also draw one line. So this is the part we won't be shading. So all of this part we won't be shading in. So this line can help you. But still, you have to follow the big line concept. So the line should get bigger. Okay, so after you have done the shading, then you have to start making more strokes, but you have to make this, we did all dark, but now we have to make medium. We have to not make it too dark, not too soft. We have to make with medium pressure. So after you have done the dark, medium and light strokes, you have to take your finger, or you can also take a tissue and start blending it. If you don't have a tissue, you can also use a finger like me. And then blend it until you can see a gradient coming from the dark to the light. And then now after you've done the shading here, you take your eraser and then you, at the corner of this, you have to erase everything. So you have to make everything white here. So after you've done this, we're going to go on the bottom. So in the bottom, you have to do medium strokes, you have to do light strokes. And then you have to do it all the way until the part when it starts curving up. So after you've done that, you have to just blend a bit. And you have to blend it up. You cannot blend it here or there or somewhere else. You have to blend it up like this. So after you blend it up, we're going to go on this side. So first take your pencil and then make medium strokes like this. And when you reach the part where it's going in, you have to make big strokes. So you have to make strokes like this. So after you have done these, it's time to blend it with your finger. And after you blend it, it will look a little bit like this. Now, as you can see, in the middle it looks a little weird. That is that there's two dark, there's two sides is dark and one side is white. So that's why we will connect both of these strokes together with really, really light lines. You have to barely put pressure on the paper. So now it's time to shade inside. So it's time to blend. So inside, so let's blend using our finger. After we blended this, we're going to start blending the top. So we are going to focus on the top, but you will think that we have to just continue these shadows to the top. Yeah, we have to do that. But there's one more thing. The stem is giving a shadow on the pineapple. So there should be one part which should be really dark than the others. So we will make you have to make medium strokes, and then you have to make circular motions. For the strokes, we are usually doing them like this, but now we have to do them like this. So let's do it. And then after you do that, you just blend it again. And you have to keep this part light. So this part should be light. Now we'll have to do the second last step, which is just shading this part. So you can see next to the stem, this part, you have to use medium strokes on it. Basically kind of the same darkness as the shadow. And then you have to connect all of this top. You have to not leave a blank space like this. And then start blending. So our stem looks little plain. So now let's start shading on the stem. So this part of the stem has to be dark. And then the middle of the stem is also going to be dark. But make sure while you're doing that, you leave a little white space. And then just blend it with your finger. And then to finish off the blending on the stem, you have to just make a dark spot at the top. So now you can just do anything around it. I'm just going to write my signature. So that's how you make a pear and then shoot. How to draw and shade a pear easily. So I told you how to use shapes and that all, which made it really easy. I didn't make many videos for so long because I was learning how to shade, how to sketch, and how to do realism. So in my next video, I'm gonna show how to draw real eyes. So I hope you like my video. Please make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Later.